Yeah, you wanna check out the back porch? So it's basically a 6x6 in there, wrapped with two 2x12s on this side and two 2x6s on this side. So, and then we actually anchored, I had brackets custom made that were cast right into the ICF that the beams sit on, the rafters sit on. So, and then they're bolted into that, so they're not going anywhere. People who come periodically see these large incremental changes, but I see this continuum, and so for me it's like, isn't it just the same? Right now we're at the top of the main staircase. My wife and I really struggle with a name for this part of the house. It's like a foyer, a hallway. That's the elevator right there. So the elevator, you know, that services all the way from the basement to the attic will let you out here. This is the guest wing down this way, where the two guest bedrooms. My wife claimed this bedroom as her craft room, even though it's really a bedroom. We've got it set up with lots of outlets and stuff for her crafting. And then back this way, starting at this point, is the master suite, which is, you know, pretty extensive. Oh, we haven't seen that. We didn't do the basement. A lot of mechanical stuff down there. So we decided to go with geothermal because we had a lot of water on the property, number one. And number two, the geothermal system is like 4 to 5 times as efficient as a gas or just regular electric system. So even though this house is like 4 or 5 times bigger than my current house, the amount of money it's gonna cost per month to heat this house is the same as with my little house. And that's because for every dollar of energy I put into the geothermal unit, I get $4 or $5 equivalent of heating or cooling out of them. Whereas right now, at like my current house, I have a really nice high efficiency Bryant gas furnace, 93-94% efficient. Every dollar I put into that thing, I get 93 or 94 cents worth of heat out of it. These, I put a dollar of electricity through the geothermal unit and I get $4 or $5 equivalent heat or cool out of them. So it's really, you know, very efficient. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how it works. I'm really, you know, the ICF isn't that hard to work with, and it's, you know, it's got so many pluses. I'll show you how this works, because this is, now there's a strap in here, and you don't want to cut the strap. That's step one. And that's pretty much it. Now it makes a lot of, I call it snow, but the only thing you have to do after that is kind of chase in there and clean out the little bits of foam that are kind of still caught in there. But usually you just run a knife or something. I mean, it's pretty clean. And then you feel around to make sure there's no concrete or anything. Occasionally there'll be one of the teeth missing from the block and it'll fill with concrete. But you're basically ready to shove your wire in there now with the patent pending wedge. You just shove the wire in there and poke it back. We're getting there. I figure I'm about 18 months from done. The last piece of trim painted, the last nail set and filled, you know, done. So we'll be in before that though. You know, as soon as we have working all the mechanical, as soon as the drywall's done in here, we can turn on the the geothermal units and get some heat in here. So as I'll tell you, some nights when you come home from work, it's kind of a little bit of a struggle to put on your coveralls and come out here and work until dark, then repeat.
For more information about BuildBlock ICFs, visit BuildBlock.com and visit our YouTube channel, youtube.com/BuildBlock.